How do we connect? Oh, we're live.
All right, hey guys, this is Laura coming to you from Houston, Texas, and tonight I'm going to show you how to make the really cute tassel that I posted the other day. So this is the tassel that we're going to be making in this live video, and what I will post to my blog later is the file for this. So you can use a 12 by 24 sheet of Cricut faux leather, and so I made different sizes. Tonight we're going to use the purple one to cut, but I've used this brown one for the example. So I've already got it on my mat, and Cricut also is very intuitive, and it has a setting for faux leather. So I've chosen that, and I just will have to press go. And it's going to do its thing. Hopefully. Perfect. So I will put this here. All right. Okay. So now on to the tassel. So this is nice and flat. And I've pre-cut some for you to see. So this is what it's gonna look like when I'm finished, or this is what's gonna look like when I'm finished. And this is what it looks like when it comes off the mat. So it's just like curled. So I went to the Google and I said, how do you iron out leather or faux leather? And it said that faux leather is made of plastic. So proceed with caution. But I'm using my Cricut Easy Press set at 275. And it said, the Google said to place the leather in a towel.
Hey Laura, what does it look like if you don't do what you're about to do?
Oh, okay. Sorry. So if you don't do it, like if you don't iron it, it is going to look like this. This is the first one I made. And this just looks messy and kind of undone. So we're going for this look right here. Okay. So make sure you flatten out all of these little threads. Press for 30 seconds.
Laura, what's some things that you learned while doing your first round with the sizes?
Oh, okay, so I made a bunch of paper ones, and I highly recommend using paper because paper is cheaper than faux leather. So this is the blue one. But the cords I got didn't come that short, and so I had to adjust for the length of the cord. So the width is going to be 11.5, and the height is going to be anywhere from, I think this is 5 to 6, so I'm cutting it at 6 right now. All right, now turn it over. Okay. So paper is cheaper than leather all the time. So I just use my scraps and cut out all of these to make sure that what my actual cut was correct, was what I wanted. So this is almost done.
Megan wants to know, what setting do you use to cut the leather? I can never get mine to cut all the way.
So I use the Cricut faux leather setting, Megan, and I've cut 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 at this point. So you can see on my mat, it is going through. So Megan Polis, will you come behind here and show them that I actually put painter's tape across the top to hold it down. And this is gonna, this piece of faux leather is actually gonna cut 6 tassels. And then it'll leave a scrap at the bottom. So you can cut more, but they just have to be smaller. Okay, so you see how nicely that turned out. Not curled at all, just like the other ones. Okay, so the next thing I wanna do is I wanna put a crease in it. So this one's already creased. So I'm just gonna fold that down like that and then take it back to the press. And so 30 more seconds. I'm gonna give it 15. Okay. That should do it. Okay. Whoopsie.
What are the items? Megan, these are the tassels that we're making. So this is her first tassel, and what happens when you don't use the heat press to flatten the faux leather, but then this is the nice product it looks like when you're done. And so these are 11-inch iPhone cords, so 12-inch iPhone cords that she's hidden in there. So when it's done, it's a cute little tassel. You can put on your keychain or
your belt loop.
On your belt loop. I use this at a game day and connected it with a portable charger and charged my phone in my back pocket. Something easy to carry around, but also not a random cord in your purse.
Okay, so I'm struggling to get that done, but I will carry on because I pre-made this before. Okay. So, now that you've got that nice and creased, you're going to find your cord. Okay. So, you're going to roll, fold the cord in half and roll it into the tassel. So, I'm gonna do this. And you want to get it as tight as possible so that the tassel cap fits over it. So these would make great Christmas gifts. I saw them at Target for a retail price of $9 each. You can make this for less than $9. I think I figured I can make 6 of them for $8 each. And it's something that's like made by you. Okay, so it fits. Now I'm going to take it out, unroll it, and then glue it. So you'll want to, I use E6000 for this project.
Lauren wants to know where you got your tassel caps from.
Okay, so Joanne, I got the silver one from Joanne. They're $5 each. I think they're on sale for $2.99 right now. But I was in the Hobby Lobby the other day and found the exact same one for $3 for 2. So this is the Hobby Lobby one. And I got a gold and a bronze. I think that they have a silver too, but I already had silver caps, so I did not buy that. And that's $2.99 without a coupon. So if like you're going to Hobby Lobby and that's the only thing you're getting, it's $2.99. Or if you can get 40% off with a coupon. But who goes into Hobby Lobby and only gets one thing? Let's be honest. All right.
Putting one little piece of glue on the very end.
Yeah. And then I'm also gonna put glue on the top. To hold it in.
Where did you find the charging cord?
Amazon. So these were $5 for $10 on Amazon. And Prime. So if you have Prime, you can get them in 2 days. Okay, there we go. And now, so these tassels, what's great about them is they come with like these little screws. So you can ensure that it's not gonna come out. Screw it in.
Laura, what do you like most about your Cricut maker?
Everything. My very first Cricut was a personal cutter, the baby bug. And we've come a long way since then. But my first Explore is, I still have it. And I still use it if I'm trying to double task. But I think the best thing about the maker is the ability to cut more materials. I bought it because I have, I do these projects with the states, the 50 states cartridge, and I will, it's gonna, the knife blade is coming out in 2018, and it's gonna give me the ability to cut balsa wood. And so, honestly, that I bought it because of that, because I don't do anything with fabric. My sister does, but I have no desire to do anything with fabric. It can cut fabric, and I got the stuff, all the mats to cut fabric, but I don't think I ever will. Okay, so that is done. And it took, Megan, what time are we at?
I don't know when it started.
Okay.
And Facebook Live doesn't tell me these things.
Oh, okay.
Hashtag rookie. Shouldn't you come over there? Kayla says hey.
Hey girl. Okay, so I'm gonna peel this off.
So we paused it and we're peeling off the blue one. So do you have any friends who love blue? Maybe went to Auburn.
I don't know.
Go Tigers.
Go Tigers. Okay, so these are very pretty blues. I love this color actually, and I did not go.
Hey Pat. Pat says hi from Savannah, Georgia.
Hi Pat. Thank you for joining us. I'm gonna do it again. In case you're just joining, I'm just gonna do the same thing. This one didn't curl so much.
And they're also still connected, so it's easier.
Yeah. Oh right. And so I've had this on the mat for a day, 24 hours, 48 hours. Okay. So, if you're just now joining us, you want to iron your faux leather, normally it's super curls. This isn't super curled, but this is what you're gonna get if it's like super curly. And you can go back and watch this video from the beginning to see how curled this one was before I ironed it. Okay. So the heat press is at 275, 30 seconds. Do y'all have any questions?
Candy needs a heat press.
Yes, you do.
I like the smaller heat press. My sister has a monster heat press.
Yeah. Okay, so now...
Did you make the tree behind you? Oh, I painted that. And I ripped it off of something on Pinterest. And I projected it onto the wall, stenciled it out, and then painted it.
Hashtag fullest Pinterest project.
Hashtag fullest Pinterest project. When it all started 5 years ago. Laura had mentioned how she got the charging cords off of Amazon with her Amazon Prime account. Was it the 12 inches?
The 12 inches are 5, 4, 10.
Okay.
I can't seem to find any 7 inches. I ordered 7 inches, but they actually are 11 inches. But I only paid $10 for 10 of them. So I'm just gonna go with it. I'm just gonna go with it.
So normally do you flip that over and heat press both sides?
Yes. Now I heat press, I mean, it's pretty flat. So I'm gonna try.
You end up keep pressing it down when you pour it, when you hold that.
Yeah, I'm gonna hope this works this time. Okay. So okay. Oh, that other, it's really messed up. Do one more. So I tested it with paper. So always test with paper before you actually cut. So, for a price breakdown, I paid $8 for the leather. It was on sale. It's usually $10, but I think at Hobby Lobby it was 25% off, so I paid $8. I paid $1 each for my charging cords, and then I paid $3 for the tassel caps. So $1.50 for a tassel cap. I can make 6 tassels out of this 12x24 leather. So $1.66 each for the leather. And then $1 for the cord.
So $1.50, $2.50,
$4.16.
We'll believe her. So much cheaper than Target, where they are $9 for this same thing. And so,
and even if your cord, you did the 10 or 5 for $10, and that would still only be $5.16.
Right. Yeah. Okay.
So it fits. Ooh, I like that.
Ooh, yeah, me too. I like that a lot. So, a cheap gift for under $5.
Hashtag stop and suffer.
Yeah, and hashtag everyone. Every gift this Christmas can be these little tassels.
Okay. Pair it with a portable charger, you'll have the winning gift.
Yeah. If you have a white elephant party and the price point is $10, you can easily do this. Yeah. It's done!
It finally stopped. Well done. So we already ripped the other two off. And then you take this off and you still have some left to save for later, or if you want to, if you're able to find, if you just want to do a regular tassel without the cord, or you can find a smaller cord than the 12 inch ones. It looks like 11 inches where we're at right now. We might try to find the 7 inch ones that was supposed to come in, but they were 11 inches.
Yeah. Okay, so
that one's a little more curlier, which is a good thing you have the heat press. So that'll be two. So a total of
six
out of an $8 roll of leather. Okay. So you put the glue on the inside and then at the end.
Yeah.
And then now on top.
Yeah. So I'm gluing this.
Laura, what kind of glue is that? Sarah Jo wants to know.
Oh, E6000. I think I heard about it in this group. It's like super sticky and super strong. Oh no. I don't want to ruin my towel.
Does it take long to dry, the glue?
So I think the bottle says it cures in, this one's not going in, 24 to 48 hours. Okay, good. Okay. But, so this, I don't know why they want you to glue the tassel, because these tassel caps come with these little tiny screws that you will screw them in. I guess the glue is just for extra measure. Okay.
Is there something else you're thinking about using your Cricut Maker for soon?
Yes.
What's your next project?
My next project is going to be a stencil. So I got stencil vinyl
and I'm going to cut out the stencil with my Cricut Maker and make like plaques with a bottle opener on it. So I'm not gonna fit it well. So, easy screwing, easy to screw it in. You just need a mini screwdriver if you don't already have one. I got a set from Joann's for like $5. And there you have it, another cute little tassel. And they're two different lengths. And as I said at the beginning of the video, I will be sharing this, the instructions on my blog at projectsbypolis.com, and you can go back and rewatch the video to see how I made these. Thanks for
coming. Michael, real fast, Michael wants to know, can you show where both ends of the charging cord is? So, so the middle of it's up in the cap, and then it's hidden within the cord. So this can easily go on your keychain, on your purse, and then the cord is hidden, and it's also accessible. And then Karen, did you make the Cricut cutting file yourself? And yes.
Oh, yeah. So, okay. So I used an existing file. The Cricut has a tassel file. And so I used that to make this. And so I'm going to share that file. So in the file, the tan is the tan. And it is for a 12-inch cord. And the blue, I think, is the purple. Is the purple one. And so, and I'll mark all of that stuff, like I'll mark it in the file before I share it, but that file is going to be available on my blog at projectsbypolis.com. So the tan, the purple, and then if you're really lucky and you find a really short cord, you can use the blue, or you can just use the blue to make, so like this is the size difference with the blue. This is what the blue would cut it out to, but they didn't send me the right size cord. So, if there's no more
questions. So this is a 12-inch cord, this is an 11-inch cord?
Yes, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Perfect. All right. Thank you for coming, guys, and y'all have a good night.